This is not good credibility at all. Hello everyone, we are still in the hotel, and because of that, I figured why not do my overnight curls hair tutorial. My hair looks really bad because it's like day 2.5 hair living in Houston humidity. So I just figured I'd walk y'all through what my overnight hair tutorial is. The first step of it is to take a shower. So I'm gonna do that right now. I've been listening to a lot of Becky G in my shower, so whatever suits your fancy. The products I use in the shower depend literally on where I'm at. So when I'm in Austin, I use the Biologica Color Lash Shampoo. I recently did buy the It's a 10 Miracle Gloss and Glaze Conditioner. To be honest, I just picked it up because I like the packaging, but I was back at home and the one I just have in my shower back there is the TG shampoo and TG conditioner. None of these products I recommend y'all are set in stone, by the way. For background, my hair is very much traditional Asian hair. Very thick strands and lots of it. So in high school, I had the biggest issue finding products that actually tend for my hair. But ever since my sophomore to senior year of college, I think I've found a routine that actually protects my hair, which is nice. Therefore, I just wanted to share with y'all if y'all are looking for products or just a way to style your hair in a protective way. I let my hair chill out for a bit. I towel dry, but now I just do my skincare routine, brush my teeth, all of that. It's very simple. It's not a hard hair routine, I would say. So I'm gonna do that right now and get back to you. I didn't realize I could turn on the light on this mirror too. Wait. I don't know if I like that actually. Wait. Okay, we're back. I did have like a 3-minute jam sesh to the fams. They've been on their 10-year greatest hits tour for like a year now, and they haven't even dropped any info on North America. It just makes me so sad because they went to Australia and did their whole Europe thing already. But where's love? Like, I feel like I've been a pretty loyal Vamps fan since I was 12. It's been like a decade, like come on, like 10 years, come on, like please. Ugh, it makes me so sad. If you're seeing this right now, comment down below your favorite Vamps song. Cause I do think they're really underrated. Like I'm not even just saying it, like to say, like I love the Vamps. I got back into them during COVID 2020, like in the spring. Oh my gosh, like that was my soundtrack of the freaking summer when it was like, Wild Heart, Can We Dance? Like that was just my jam. It really got me through everything in that summer. Okay, now I just kind of do that. Like, yeah, I don't know the term for it. I just see people do it and then I also do it. And I do have to mention this hair tutorial isn't for all hair types. My dad actually has curly hair. My mom has thick straight Asian hair. So it really leaves me with an odd hair texture that I didn't grow into until I hit puberty, so in middle school. Like sometimes hair will fall out and it's like a ringlet. It's insane. And then after I'm done kind of towel drying it, I flip it back and forth 10 times just to get any extra water out. Yeah, okay. And because I do that, I don't really brush out my hair because by physics, it makes it straight already in a sense. But also I don't really brush my hair because it'll just take out the texture it already has in there. And when I wrap it, it already has the form, if that makes sense. That definitely did not make sense, but whatever. And also my haircut right now, my aunt works at a really nice hair salon, so she does my haircuts. I get face framing pieces with long layers, and this is the shortest my hair has been since high school probably, and I don't know how I feel about it. I was watching old vlog clips from earlier this summer, like in late May, and I was like, oh my gosh, my hair. Will I go back to, it feels really nice, I will say that, but I don't know, I feel like long hair does really fit me. Did y'all ever watch that Meredith Foster video from like 2009 of her bleaching her hair with lemon? Were y'all victim to that? Cause I was. And it low-key did work. And then I went to like seventh grade history class and I was telling my friend about it. And then our friend behind us was like, oh, my sister does that, but it's like really bad for your hair and you'll get cancer. And I'm like, so I never did it again. But I don't know, it did work for a second. Do y'all also remember Kool-Aid hair? That was a, I personally did not do that, but no judgment if you did. What are some other weird hair phases I had? I'm pretty sure in fourth grade, I cut my hair in a lob, like this length, just because Selena Gomez did for season 4 or 3 of Wizards of Waverly Place. You know, when she like did her hair transformation and was like super short, literally got it because of her, because of that. Yeah. And I will say, when you look up hair inspiration on Pinterest, picking people with your same face shape is so key. Not really something I thought about until like a couple years ago. The way your face shape and your hair match like makes the biggest thing. That's why when I look for hair inspo, I not even joke to you, not saying that I look like these people, but just like face shape wise, I look at photos of Selena Gomez and Jennie from Blackpink. I'm being dead ass. Just to see how it literally lies, like how every follicle like will lie on the head shape that already exists on another person, and you show that. Cause I can't show some photo of a white girl with literally the smallest face ever and expect my hair to look like that. Like no, like I won't have any hair because her head is already small, so she already has less hair. So that was like really aggressive. I didn't mean, like it's, hair is just a very personal thing to me. Like I'm not even joking, my mood the following day is all determined on how my curls come out from like the night, how I do it the night before. So if this turns out bad, I'm scrapping this entire video and none of y'all are gonna see it. But in the meantime, I let my hair dry. It's 8:30 right now. I start wrapping it around 10:30 before I get to bed. So right now, if you're following this tutorial, you can chill out. I usually like to watch YouTube, so I'm probably gonna do that. And yeah, I'll see y'all in 2 hours with somewhat drier hair. Dude, how did I literally forget? Okay, I actually used air dry cream on my hair. I didn't start doing this until this past winter, so for about 6 months I've been using this. I do think it makes a difference on how my hair holds the curl. I don't know if this could be achieved by a mousse as well or an oil, but I honestly really like the smell of this air dry cream as well. It smells like a really nice perfume. Not like too grandma-y, like Chanel. Oh, I cannot stand Chanel No. 5 or what's another one? I cannot stand those, I'm sorry. I use up this much, spread it, and then just work it through my hair. You can also, I think you can use this on dry hair too, but I like using it wet dry hair. I think it literally dries it up too much. So yeah, I just put it on when I hop out the shower after I dry it with a towel, and I think it turned out pretty good. Yeah, like this is actually disgusting. I should not be putting this on camera. I shed like a dog in the shower. It's just because my hair is really dark, really thick, so you can just see it better, so it looks really dramatic. Like I promise, I think this is normal. But also I have so much hair already that I don't care about shedding. Like honestly, I'd rather have it shed because then it'd be the normal amount of hair I would have in my head. Okay, cool. I'm gonna throw away my hair ball and let this dry for about 2 hours. All right, it's been 2 hours later and my hair is basically dry. I don't know if you're like actually following if I do this video, but which I'll do in your 2 hours. I personally was watching Modern Family and Miraculous Ladybug. So what you'll need to do the curls, a rope if you have one, but if you don't, then you can also use a pair of leggings, a tank top that you roll around. I've literally used everything I've said, but go find an old rope and use the rope from it. Like literally use what you have. And then you're just gonna need 2 scrunchies. So first you're gonna put the rope around the head. But first you're gonna put your part where you actually want it, and I actually like to do mine a bit off center, so then when I do a middle part when I wake up, it naturally has volume when it goes back to the middle part. So I'm gonna do it to my right side a little bit, place my rope in the middle of my head, and then split your hair into 2 sections. You can pick which side you want to work with first, but it's gonna be the same steps on either side, so when I show you that, I'll just do the same side, not needing to explain it. So because I have face framing layers, I like to grab this section first. Okay, now that I grab my face framing pieces, I'm gonna do this first section away from my face all the time I do that, just so I get that swoop. So you're gonna take it and wrap it around kind of higher than it would just go down. So kind of angle it up and then wrap it around the rope once. And then you should see it return back to the front side. And then you're gonna grab a piece a bit farther away from your head. You can either do that or do it directly from where you picked up your last section. It doesn't really matter, honestly. I'll just do it from directly the next section just to show y'all. Grab this, and then for this piece, actually, I like to wrap it going towards my face just so it adds more volume to my hair. When I had longer hair, I used to just wrap it all one way. Like, I just kind of French braid it in a sense, but like rope French braid. So many words, oh my gosh. But now that I have shorter hair, I like more volume with it. So that's just what I'm doing. But if you wanna try it out the other way, then you totally can, no one's stopping you. You're gonna take that piece, wrap it around the front. So now both pieces are at the front. And then this is where you just keep doing that again and keep adding pieces to these first two. So with the piece that's coming away from my face, I'm gonna grab a piece from behind and then add it to that first piece. It can get confusing, but there's like a point where like it doesn't even really matter like where you're tying it, to be honest. So yeah, just keep doing that. In high school, I used to straighten my hair almost every week just due to like certain events I had, or like if I was on dance team. So when we had football games, our protocol was like you have to have your hair styled, obviously. So every morning, not even six in the morning, I think we'd wake up like 5:30, my mom would straighten my hair for me. But then thing is, by the time it's football game at like 8 p.m., my hair is already freaked up from the humidity in Texas and it didn't even look good. But I think I've come to like this hairstyle a lot. And yeah, ever since doing my hair in high school, I've been so sick of using heat. So I really only put heat on it like once or twice in the year. And it's really only just so I cut my hair at its level. And then after that, you're just gonna tie it off once you run out of hair. And then with the excess rope, you just like tied it. Then you're gonna repeat this with the other side. Yeah, that's basically it. I remember as a kid, I used to have a legit bob haircut with bangs too, and my nickname was Dora for like a good like first 5 years of my life. I think it just like, and then Ni Hao Kai Lan dropped, and I was like, bitch, I'm not Dora, I'm Ni Hao Kai Lan, period. There's just a certain point where you do this every day for a year straight and it just comes natural. I think that took literally 2 minutes max, probably, if I didn't have to explain the first one. Yeah. No. Oh, Elizabeth is up from Korea. Oh my god. Bro, how am I supposed to have a boyfriend looking like this? But also, I don't need one because my hair slays for myself only. Like, I sleep good. Like, I'm sleep good too because my posture is nice. Because of this, I have to sleep on my back so it doesn't mess it up. So I'm like, okay, I have to sleep on my back with good posture so my hair looks good in the morning for me, myself, and I. Okay, so now go to sleep. Like, there's really nothing else. Now, like, I think you're good. But if your hair kind of feels dry, you can spray some water on it. But I'm not fancy. I don't have a water sprayer. So what I do, I just get water from the sink and then like kind of wash my hands with it and then just pat my hair just so it gets some moisture. So it has something to cling on to at night and dry so it holds the shape. What were like the weirdest things you did in the name of like hair care? Like in high school, I would do apple cider vinegar washes. Oh my gosh, smelled horrible. Like my mom had to help me with those too, and they smelled so, my bathroom smells so bad. Oh my God. No, I'm gonna throw up if I think about it. I think it was like to clarify your scalp or something. Oh my gosh, not worth it though. Oh, like high school is a rough time for hair. Like having to like discover how your hair works and then go to school the next day at 9 a.m. and everyone be like, I remember in, fifth grade, I wore my hair in French braids at night and then next day I took them out and had like crimped hair, obviously. Went to school. Everyone was like, Vivian, your hair, like every, for some reason when you went to school and had different hair, everyone felt like they needed to say something about it. I remember in third grade too, I used to have bangs, but I was like growing them out because I was like, I don't want bangs anymore. Like, that's so old. My mom like put them in a clip so it had a little bump it, you know? And this kid named Nathan was like, Vivian, like where are your bangs? Like, elementary school, it was rough. But now, this is my like signature hair. Every time I'm like on campus, everyone is always like, how do you do hair? Now here's the answer. Hopefully it'll look good in the morning so you'll actually find me credible. But yeah, okay, I'm gonna, what time is it? Oh, I have to check out tomorrow. Okay, I'll see you tomorrow. Yeah.
I lied, I'm not actually going to sleep because I was just thinking a bit too much and now I can't sleep because I'm like, oh, like my career, like what am I doing? Because at the conference, we were at a panel discussing the role of advocacy in journalism. And let me actually find the page so I can see it verbatim. Like, be sure I don't mess this up, you know? A man on the panel stated that social media is inherently white capitalistic because back in the early days of things such as newspaper, these journalists learned that being more neutral helped them to sell more. And what social media does is it affirms people's identities and how they view themselves in the world. What are y'all's thoughts on that? I don't know. Someone who is 20 years old, grew up with almost every social media, like literally YouTube, I remember the start of it. And then obviously everything else, like growing up in middle school with it, whole different rodeo. But like, I'm sorry if me seeing a shirt I like on Pinterest kind of plays into my identity. Like, I'm just a girl. Like, okay, I will say it was like a white man who said that. And I was like, you just don't get it. You just don't get it. Like, you weren't on the internet when driver's license dropped. I'm like, you weren't there. You were not there. You weren't on the internet when Connor Franta left O2L either. And I'm saying this as someone who like honestly has stepped back from social media this past year in college. Sometimes I do miss it though, to be honest, because I feel disconnected to my friends. And that raises the question of, oh, social media is white capitalistic, we should all delete it. I don't think that's the answer, because media is ever changing, as we all know. And to tell people to just delete it, that separates them. Also just like disconnect them from news, not just like NPR news that you can get like on any website, but people have become like unofficial journalists through their phones, through making short videos, posting about it, and then people gaining knowledge from it. Like, if there's like, do the pros, But yeah, when he said that, I was like, I don't know about that. Because honestly, I think a lot of people, like, okay, for example, I'm Vietnamese American, 20 years old, born in the States. I'm kind of disconnected to like my roots. Like, I'm still like in the ground, but maybe like topsoil, you know? I'm not like, you feel? So honestly, I learned a lot of Vietnamese language in general, but also culture through my Instagram, because I would say like 1/3 of the people I follow are Vietnamese American, like either be cooking videos or just people who make content in Vietnamese and just like vlogs as well. I consume it and I'm like, wow, I just feel so honed in. So how can you, like, I just don't get, that's just a very broad statement, I would say. So I don't know if I would agree with social media being inherently white capitalistic. I mean, like, okay, Facebook was created by literally a white guy. Wait, I'm getting it confused with The Social Network. I'm like, Andrew Garfield, but Edward, I don't know. I can't think about this too much any longer. I need to like go to sleep before I literally like drop out of my last year of college. Good night for actually. Yeah. I'll see you tomorrow.
Okay, I've been up for like 2 hours. It's 9 a.m. right now. I was literally on Reels just watching stuff. What do y'all get on your Reels? Because I've been getting a lot of stand-up comedy. Some of them like aren't that good, but the people make it bearable to watch. Okay, so it's next morning, obviously. I'm just gonna take out the hair. Hopefully this looks good. I accidentally left my Spotify playing on the whole night because I typically do the sleep setting to only play for like an hour. So I woke up at 7 a.m. with Part of Me by Katy Perry playing. I think that was a good start to my morning. It was weird because I felt it was like pop music. I think I had like an old playlist playing because usually I put on like my 2000s alt rock, like Dallas radio playlist. I'll switch it up today. Okay, so the rope has been taken out and let's see what this looks like. I might need to go to the mirror because I can't really see it through this camera. Oh wait, okay. Oh wow, okay, it looks perf. And then sometimes I do put the air dry curling, what was it? Air dry cream in throughout the hair. But I think it looks good today. Like, I don't think I need to do it. Oh, cute. And then, again, because I put it on a different section, then I just, like, run the top part through. And obviously don't brush it out, unless you want to. I actually usually just brush the front section so that these pieces are kind of softer. So I'm going to actually do that. Oh, so cute. Nice. And then I can just get my brush and sweep it through the top section. Boom. Perf. Okay. That's literally my overnight curls hair tutorial. And throughout the day, obviously, it softens. But you can put hairspray on this. I put hairspray on it sometimes if I know like I need my hair looking better later in the night. But this is pretty much it for me. Okay, I really need to go pee now. So yeah, ending off this video. Thank you so much if you watched to the end of this, and if you actually like use this hair tutorial, send me a photo. Okay, yeah, that's my hair tutorial. Thank you, and I bet if you're like following along in this morning, but like do whatever with your day. Okay, bye.